Perfect. Now, we're standing here in the grounds of Glin Parish Church on the eve of a major gala performance by the Celtic Tenors, internationally known, in fact, actually just after returning from a major tour in Vancouver, Southern America, and parts of Europe. And Glin Development Association have organized a major concert here this evening to raise necessary funds to enhance the activities and projects of people living in the town of Glin and its districts. Now, the first time that the Celtic Tenors performed here in Glin was in 2011. So 6 years on, they have arrived back. And in between that, 2012 and onwards, different artists and groups have performed here in the church on an annual basis at Christmas time for raising of necessary funds for the parish. So I'll be talking a little later on to the chairman of Glin Development Association, John Anthony Calhan, and other project leaders who have done marvellous work in 2017 to raise necessary funds as well. So we'll be having a chat with them a little later on. So for the moment, Gordabila Market, August Lawn. Now, here in the wonderful grounds of the Glin Parish Church, we're delighted to have the members of the Celtic Tenors who are performing here in the church on an annual basis, actually, for the last 6 years. But the first time was 6 years ago when the Celtic Tenors graced their fantastic professional voices, known locally, internationally, right across the board as highly professional people. James Gilson and James Nelson, sorry, and Matthew Gilsonen. You see, that's one of my weaknesses. I can never remember.
That's not
names.
A bad news. You got Gilsonen, which a lot of people don't get.
Yeah, I know. But it's great to have you here. Now, I know that you're just waiting on your colleague as well to come from Oma.
I don't.
But when did the Celtic Tenors actually start?
Kind of kicked off in around, it had sort of soundings of beginnings in kind of mid-90s, I suppose, when there was a group called the Irish Tenors, but it kind of, that ran its course a little bit, and James came across me. I was on a break from an engineering career in an opera in Dublin, and we all got together. We did a period of time in Clontarf Castle with Rebecca Storm, actually.
Oh, yes.
And it was a fantastic experience. I went from zero to fairly high level with the lads. They brought me up. After 137 performances, and we got signed to a record deal with EMI Classics in late 99, and in 2000 we changed our name to the Celtic Tenors, and that's when the Celtic Tenors began. So the first album was brought out in January or February 2000.
So that's nearly 17 years, the best part of 17 years on the go.
In 2005-2006 there was one change in the lineup. In the early configuration, there was a tenor called Niall Morris. He was in for the first 5 years, but got a bit tired of the international touring and the travel and everything. And Daryl was brought in, Daryl Simpson, who strangely, we had, three of us had been in an opera with, in Opera Ireland in the Gaiety in 1999. So we hadn't met before, so he has been here ever since. And Daryl added the guitar to the group as well, because the three of us, sing, obviously, and we have our musical director. Tonight is Kian Sweeney from Cork, but Daryl plays guitar as well, so.
The one thing about opera, do you mind me asking you, is it one of the hardest performances to give? Because often you hear opera in different languages. So, like trying to understand and the emotion in a different language, is that very difficult? Never mind actually remembering the actual words.
I think when it comes to opera, it has been a part of you for so many months.
Right.
You know it inside out, you know what every syllable means. That's kind of the easy part, if you like.
Yes.
The emotion is also the easy part if you have an ounce of acting in your body.
Right.
The difficulty is, James and our favourite tenor was a man called Jussi Björling from Sweden. One of the most amazing tenors that has ever lived. But he said it kind of very well, very, very succinctly, I think. He said that the difficulty is you don't always sound like you did on the recordings. When you're singing an opera, you are absolutely exposed. You're at the edge, at the limit of what's possible for the human voice,
right,
particularly as a tenor. So there's that. So there's always this fear.
Yeah.
there's always a fear, and there's always this underlying kind of tension of, is it going to go wrong? Maria Callas, when she was singing opera, you didn't sit back and watch her. You were on the edge of your seat. Is she going to crack this note?
Right.
And if she, when she doesn't, it's amazing.
Is that something like the performance of Nessun Dorma, when they get to the very, very highest?
They're waiting for the beat.
And you're just waiting. Yeah, yeah, it exactly. It is.
And there's a part of the audience who kind of almost wants it, not to fail, yeah, but they're kind of, is he going to do it? Is he going to do it?
Because it is. It's a natural, isn't it? Yeah, yeah.
And yeah, we are all trained in Italian when you go through the classical training, and even German and French and everything. But a few years ago, we were touring China with David Brophy conducting a local
orchestra.
Oh, David,
yes.
Yeah, absolutely.
The Choirs of Angels.
We thought
Ages, yeah. Fantastic.
Absolutely, yeah. We thought we'd sing a song in Mandarin. It took forever to learn. Now, that was difficult, you know. But I still can remember it, you know.
Yes.
It had been like all those years ago.
And so we got a standing ovation after every verse.
Because we got to the trouble of remembering it.
But no, our opera. But having said that, opera isn't all that we're about. I think what we have developed into over the years is just a singing group that sings what we believe are good songs. So whether it's a folk song or an Irish dancey song or grand opera or anything in between. I mean, we've even recorded "I'm All Out of Love" with Air Supply, and we toured with them for a little while in America. So we believe that a good song is a good song, and the way you sing, you can tailor it to what you're singing. So it can be, you have a various set of tools in your toolbox. You use whichever tool you need for that particular song.
But our most recent album as well was released by Decca Universal, and it's called Timeless, and it's songs from our youth. Because we're a very harmony-based group as well, three-part harmony, switching all the time. And there are songs by John Denver, Dolly Parton, Simon and Garfunkel. So it's quite a departure, but it's gone really, really well. And so being the show.
For the people of Glin and actually surrounding areas, they're coming from Limerick City, they're coming from parts of North Cork, parts of Clare, Tipperary. They're all coming here to Glin this evening to hear you. And it's no wonder why. Now, what type of, how would I say, assortment of music do people be expecting to hear?
Christmas, obviously Christmas songs.
Yes.
A few Irish songs. A lot of songs from this new album, Timeless. John Denver and Dolly Parton and all those. And some opera, some classical.
Fantastic.
A few acapellas. A bit of everything. Literally something for everything in the audience.
I think the general tenor of the show is that it's like a variety show, but it's very, very calm. And it's fun. There's a lot of fun going on. Sorry about that. That fun, laid back nature,
and
that sort of thing.
That's our musical director.
Hello, how's it going?
Great haircut.
This is pretty impromptu.
This has been cast live. So you better get in there.
Actually, my first point to you. First of all, you're very welcome to be in. Great to have you.
Yeah,
I'm sure the people in Glin will be delighted with your performance tonight with the Celtic Tenors.
Nice haircut.
Tell me, how is it a young man like you has such a high degree in music? Musical director.
Oh, I don't know.
She's very talented. Actually, in America last week, there were a few people that came to, it was East Texas, and some people came to some other friends of ours who were there, and they said, so which one is the doctor? And what do you mean? The MD? Who is the MD?
But actually, he had last week, we sang, our last show was with Symphony Orchestra, and he had the premiere of one of his arrangements, symphony arrangements, so with the orchestra.
Well, symphony orchestra.
So there's a high degree of it.
It's your cousin.
Oh, wow. And the very best of both of you.
And so it's been a stepper for the women.
Of different styles of music tonight.
Absolutely. Yeah. And it's fun, and it's what we do is we engage the audience, we get the audience singing.
Yep.
He in here is a fantastic addition because he's a genius to watch and wonderful to watch on piano. He's very relaxed.
Not the pressure,
no, it's no pressure. Never any pressure.
Well, listen, we're delighted to come back after 6 years.
Well, thank you very much. You know, it's great to be here.
Thank you, John.
We wish you the very best of luck in your great careers.
Thank you very much, John.
Thank you indeed.
Thanks.
Thank
Love, 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 love Hey! the gas.